Good morning. All right, good morning. I think we're here. Welcome to Spring Forest Qigong Every Day. My name is Susan Churchill, and I am your leader for the week. Very excited about it. I want to wish you all a very, very, very happy new year. I also want to thank Su Ling for her beautiful, gorgeous, unbelievably generously. She's just so generous with her time and her wisdom and her love. So I want to thank her so much for her practice all last week. Okay, so here we are. It's very exciting. Today's Monday. Happy, happy new year. My name is Susan Churchill. I'm a certified trainer and certified practice group leader. I come from Chicago area, Illinois. It's Mount Prospect is the actual town name. And I pretty much lived here my whole life. So right now it's winter. And in winter, we need to help our kidney qi. So we're going to think about that. And as we're doing our practice, we'll focus on our lower dantian, which is deep behind the navel. And that is our vitality. So that's one focus. I also want you to think of your intention for your Spring Forest Qigong practice for the year of 2023. If what would happen if you did Spring Forest Qigong, say every day, or with the Spring Forest Qigong everyday practice, Monday through Friday, what would your life be like at the end of 2023? I can tell you that I've been practicing since I found it about 2.5 years ago. And unbelievably, my life has changed so much. Otherwise, I wouldn't be here right in front of you. All right. So besides that, we're also going to look, we're going to concentrate on our breathing. Let's get started. And we'll talk more in between. So I'm going to come back to my little spot. This is my little oval rug that I got from my dad. I practice here, and we're going to start bouncing. So what we want to do is breathe in through our nose and breathe out through our mouth. And we're bouncing from the knees, relaxing the body, just loosening up. We want to warm up the body. We want to wake up our qi, get it flowing. Breathing in and out deeply and gently, but in through the nose and out through the mouth. So as we're talking about breathing, if we can take deeper, more gentle breaths, we can get more oxygen. And in the normal daily life, people tend to get maybe only 60% of the oxygen and the air exchange in their lungs. But what would that do? Well, that's going to be a little less, isn't it, for our tissues, our brain, our energy. So if we can enhance our breathing, and it's not something we think about, but if we can use our focus to think about it, let's take our hands over our heads. Then we can have more energy, and our brain can be have more oxygenation in our tissues, going to help us heal so much faster and more completely. Now, when we're bouncing with our hands over our head, we're helping to release some thoughts. Let's let go of the list of things to do for today. We're also helping our heart and our lungs. Breathing in through the nose, out through the mouth, just let everything go. It's a brand new year. We're bringing it in. Breathe in all the possibilities of the new year. Breathe out any pain, any fear. We're just going to let it all go. And also, while we're doing this, let's take our hands down and we're just going to go side to side, help with our spine, get a little twist in there. If we've been like me, just got up not that long ago, then we're going to wake everything up. And if you're going to bed at this point, this is good too. And what we want to do is we want to connect our mind, our heart, and our body. If we can have that connection, we're going to get so much more out of our Spring Forest Qigong practice. So you can do this standing, sitting, or lying down. I'm doing it standing. If you need to do it sitting or lying down, please just use your visualization and you're going to get so much benefit. And remember, everything's good, better, best. So now we're going to start cupping and tapping. So I'm going to move up a little closer so you can see me. So we're going to start with the stomach channel and we tap 9 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We move up to the eyebrows and tap 9 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Cupping your hand, because we want to cup, because what the cupping does is it sends vibration and it's all about vibration. So we're going to cup the top of the head, called a byway point. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now, if you want to cradle your head in your hand, then take the other hand to the back of the head and cup 9 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We move down to the C7 vertebrae and we massage that in a circular way. We don't want to cup or slap that area. It's very sensitive. We just want to open it up. Now, this is a wonderful point because we know we've got our head, right? And then we have this skinny little neck, and then and then we have the body. So this is a connection between both. And just like we need it open for our circulation and our nervous system, we need it open for our chi to flow easily from one part of the body to the rest. Now we're going to clap and cup our elbows and under our arms. And this is going to help our heart and our lung channels wake up. So we're waking up the chi, saying, get ready, chi. We're going to do some healing practice and revitalize you. So here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Inside left elbow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Inside right elbow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Back to the underarm now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This is an awesome thing to do in the morning or anytime you feel like you need to open up your lungs. Now we kind of go to the back, and I like to say good morning to the kidneys. And since we're working on vitality and our kidney energy, we're going to do that at the beginning. So we're going to cup a little above your waistline. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and then rub with the back of our hands. All right. Next, we go and tap the tailbone. So we tap with a loose fist or open hand, and you can go up and down the sacral area to the tailbone. It's up to you. Waking up now, we're trying to get that whole spine just open up and ready to go. Next, we're going to fold our thumb in and tap at the hips. Now, not right on your bone. You want to go back a little bit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Just like the neck and the C7 was the divider between the head and the body, so are the hips between the body and the legs. So we need that open. I'm going to come back here so you can see me do the knees. We're going to cup above the knees 9 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We come back to the back of the knees. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Both sides of the left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And the right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. All right. Now we've activated the chi. Now we want to move into a higher vibration. So we go to what's called the beginning of the universe posture. Our feet are planted about shoulder width apart. Relax your shoulders. All right. And I'm going to relax because this is very exciting and a little nervous. So breathe in and out a few times. Now we're going to start with our breathing in and out through our nose. We want to take our elbows out to the sides just a little bit. And I'm just going to show you my hand position. We want our fingers open. If our fingers are open, the energy can flow. If they're closed, not so much. So we want to keep those flowing and curve your hand a little like you're holding a little ball. Okay. Feet feet shoulder width apart, shoulders relaxed, elbows out a little bit to get that energy, letting that flow. Hands back. Now let's take our chin in just a little to get a beautiful alignment of the spine. If you can, take the tip of your tongue and touch it to the roof of your mouth behind your front teeth. Put a little smile on your face. And in my practice groups, I always say, what does smile stand for? Start my internal love engine. And we're breathing in and out through our nose. Scan your body. See that your body is totally with you. Your heart, you're all connected. And we stand as if we're a pine tree. We're getting to the position of song. So we all have chi, which is energy with intelligence. And as far as our chi reaches, that's called our chi field. Now, connecting in this venue with the Spring Forest Qigong community, you are connecting with everyone who's doing this practice and everyone connected to it. And now your chi field is immense. So feel that. You might start feeling some tingling in your hands or somewhere. Let yourself feel it. Close your eyes if you're comfortable with that, so your focus goes inward. And this is called song. And as you're breathing in, since we're talking about breathing, I'd like you to try to breathe as if you're breathing through every pore of your skin. So breathing in through every pore. And when you exhale, you're going to let go of any extra tension you might have in there. It could be old data, energy from mental, physical, emotional, doesn't matter. It's just extra energy. We're going to let it go. So breathing in through all the pores, let's let that energy and chi gather in our lower dantian, which is deep behind the navel. That's our vitality center. So we want to really cultivate that. So this week, we're going to concentrate on the lower dantian to help cultivate more vitality. Not only for today, but for the whole year. We're doing the whole year. Let's do it. Now, in your next breath in, I came up with this last week, and it felt good to me, and my practice group liked it. So I'm going to introduce it. And the next breath in, as you're breathing in beautiful love and unconditional love, breathe in a little bit of helium. Helium is a gas that floats balloons, right? Our balloons float up. Let that lift you just a little bit to help you go between being and becoming. And we'll say the Spring Forest Qigong password. I am in the universe. The universe is in my body. The universe and I combine together. And now connect to your master energy. Master's authentic teacher, to the love of everyone you've ever loved and who's ever loved you. Just that beautiful, you're just so, so comfortable and trusting, and just connect to that. And in this moment, ask for what you want. What do you want from your practice today? What do you want from your Spring Forest Qigong practice throughout 2023? And we're going to start the healing movement for today, which is the first day. And the first element is wood, and that's the moving of yin and yang. So we take one hand, I'm going to move up to show you. We take our right hand over our heart, left hand over our lower dantian. And if you're new, no worries, it's all good. If I go too fast, I apologize, please forgive me, and come back tomorrow and you'll get more of it. We only get what we need at the moment. So no worries at all. And what the whole movement here is, we're going to take our top hand out and down as our left hand comes in and up, and we're making this little oval shape. Now you don't have to go way out here, but you don't want to be like on top of the body either. We want a little bit of movement. So that's our movement. We have our feet in the same position where they're about shoulder width apart. We want our knees bent a little. We don't need a locked knees. So we bend those. Again, we've got our shoulders relaxed and everything else. Tipped of the tongue to the roof of the mouth. Chin in a little smile on our face. And we'll begin. Our right hand goes up and out as our left hand comes in and up. We're going to lead this with our elbows. Now, if you're comfortable, please close your eyes. You're going to get a greater benefit from it. If not, keep them open because we want to do it whatever is right for you. Sometimes coming into Spring Forest Qigong, you have a lot of things you want help with, and you might want to go faster than is the best thing for you. So please listen to your body and use your visualization. You can visualize, you got your eyes closed, right? That's no problem. So this one's called Moving of Yin and Yang. And as we're moving our arms, our hands, let's visualize a beautiful column of light from the top of our head to the bottom of our torso. And sense the color. You can have any color you want. However, since this movement creates a vibration that we call green, you can use that as your focal color. And as we're moving our hands, leading from the elbows and feeling, focusing on our hands and fingers, we are actually moving this column of light. And this is helping us to balance the yin and yang energy in our torso. And not only overall, but within each of our like our organs, like our breathing system and circulatory system. So we're also helping to rebalance the yin and yang within those systems and between them so they communicate efficiently with each other. The more balanced we can be with our mind, our body, our spirit, our soul, the quicker we can and more completely we can heal. And as we heal, we give so much love and happiness to the world. And then that's the thank you for reminding me about happiness. So the emotion for this element, which is the element of wood, which relates to our liver in our body, is happiness. We're creating happiness vibration. And you might say, well, what good is that? Well, the liver can be affected in a negative way or not positive way by the emotion of anger. And when that, it's a normal emotion, that's fine. But when it stays in the body, when anger, multiplies to resentment, that can cause some damage to our liver. But the good news is, Master Lin always says, no worries. The good news is that we are now creating the vibration of happiness, which is inviting any blockages caused by anger in our liver to release, turn into smoke or beautiful light, and shoot out of our body. And as we're breathing in, we can even breathe in this beautiful green light. And then when we breathe out, we allow and invite any excess energy to release from the body, from our liver in particular today, and shoot out to the ends of the universe. Say thank you very much. And off you go to your next adventure. Last breath in. And as we breathe out, we'll come up and have our hands in front of our lower dantian. So I have my right hand in and my left hand's out. Neither are touching, there's space between. That's the traditional way for women, opposite for men. Do what feels right for you. Let's take 3 deep breaths. And now I would like to do a little reverse breathing or Qigong breathing. So you can find a place to sit down if you're more comfortable. I got it there, but I'm actually not going to sit down. All right. So get yourself in a comfortable position and close your eyes, relax your body. As if you're still in this song, your pine tree still nice and straight. Breathe in a little helium if you need to get back to that point. And now we're going to work on our breathing. So the first thing, as we breathe in, I will count 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1, 2, 3, 4 out. All right. In between, please keep breathing. And the first time we want to breathe in slowly and gently and just try to get a nice, deep, gentle breath in and bring in your tummy just a little, your abdomen, your lower abdomen, just a teeny bit. And then we breathe out, we're going to let it go. All right. So I'm going to count that. We'll do 2 breaths. Breathe in 1, 2, 3, 4, bring in the abdomen a little bit. Now we exhale 1, 2, 3, 4, releasing that abdomen out. One more time, breathe in 1, 2, 3, 4, and breathe out 1, 2, 3, 4. Very good. Now keep breathing. Okay. So now the second one, I'd like to add the color green because that's our color for today. So as we're breathing in, we're going to breathe in through all the pores, the beautiful color green, and bring our abdomen in a little bit. All right, let's try that for 2 breaths of 4. Here we go. Breathing in. 1, 2, 3, 4, that beautiful green light. Exhaling now. 1, 2, 3, 4, letting this green light shoot out of your body, taking any extra thoughts of the day, whatever you don't need, out it goes. One more time, breathe in. 1, 2, 3, 4, and breathing out. 1, 2, 3, 4. Beautiful. One more thing for today. I'm going to chant the sound Om as we inhale and Mwa as we exhale. I'm going to do it 4 breaths so you can try to do the breathing green light through all your pores, tummy in, or you can just relax, listen to my voice and let it happen. We're going to do 4. So when I say Om, you'll breathe in. And when I start with Mwa, you'll breathe out. Ready? Okay. Om. Mwa. Om. Mwa. Om. Mwa. Om. Mwa. Very good. Now just continue your gentle breathing. I want to thank you for participating today. We're going to do harvesting of the chi next. So what we've been doing as you're gently breathing is we've activated our chi. We connected to the highest vibration, the highest chi field to allow the most healing and complete healing for you and for everyone. And we did the movement to cultivate more chi. Our chi field is very, very large now. So we're going to bring it back and gather that beautiful chi we cultivated into our lower dantian, into our vitality center to keep, help us to have a fabulous day and week in 2023, the whole thing. So we're going to start harvesting the chi. So I'm going to take off my glasses and you can start rubbing your hands together. You've got lots and lots of points on our hands. And if you do in between your fingers, you activate even more. Then we're going to, what we're going to do is we're going to rub our face in a heart shape. So the fingers go up the nose, to around, not up the nose, but around the nose, the size of it. And there we go. And then two fingers traveling up the sides of the nose. That sounds better. Making a smiley face, making a heart shape, making everything be just so wonderful. Now we're just bringing in some of this beautiful chi. So now we're going to take our fingers and we just comb our head with light coming through our fingers into our brain, our skull, our eyes. And we're going to cup our head. And then we're going to cup the back. Let's do that. That helps wake up the brain. So we're getting some more good stuff in the brain. Come down to that C7. And then my favorite, let's rub the ears from the top to the bottom. Give me a little pull on the earlobes, which helps to detox the liver. Nice. Now, since I can't see you, I'm going to put my glasses back on. All right. Take your left arm out, and we're going to cup from the shoulder down to the wrist. And we turn our arm over and do the other side. So let's do that two more times. One more time. Now we move to the right side. Shoulder to wrist. Turn your hand over, your arm over. Second time. Third time. All right, and we go to the torso and we pat down the torso. Bringing this in, this is soothing exercises under the left armpit and down the sides. There's so many wonderful points, so many wonderful things to learn about, and we can't all learn it in 30 minutes, unfortunately. Let's take our hands, put them together like this, and rub our tummy. Try to do it in a clockwise way. That would be like across to the left, down to the right, up, across the left. But don't worry about it. Just say, I'm doing it in a clockwise way. Beautiful. Now we come back to the kidneys. We want to love those kidneys, cupping those 9 times, rubbing with the back of the hands, rubbing with the front of the hands. And then we're going to do my favorite. I love the neck and whole body dolphining. We'll just do 4 of the body dolphining. So let's take our hands and put them on the kidneys so we can have that strength there. And then we just take our chin out and down as we bend over. Then the knees fold in. And then we start pushing through the hips and the rest of the body kind of comes up. And we're just imagine we're a dolphin playing in the ocean. I love this so much because when I started, I really couldn't do it very well. I felt one side was strong, the other one wasn't. And it's so wonderful to do that now. So, and of course you don't have to do it that big of one, but that's what I like to do. Okay, let's tap our tailbone, get some more energy coming here. Go to our hips, knees, and we'll just do 3 or so because I'm running out of time. You can always do more of these exercises as it feels for you. Last one coming on the toes and down the heels. Very good. I want to thank you so much. Please come tomorrow, ask your friends, and I hope you had a wonderful time. Happy, happy New Year. Thank you.